not actually completely hollow. There's nothing holding up at all apart from the grip that the calcium carbon has on the gate doors. So someday this will actually fall down. But let's hope that isn't today, because that'd be very stressful for me. It would be exciting to use though, I do have to say.
What does that look like on the gate? Is it flat or is it solid?
It looks like, that's a different question to ask. There would be like a thin layer of sand that's stuck to the calcium carbon. But yeah, inside it, there's nothing.
Okay.
Yeah. So yeah, it would be like slightly mushroom. Brown because of the thin layer of sand. But I mean, it's like, it could just be stuck to it. It would, yeah, I mean, if less calcium carbonate starts getting to it, that becomes weaker, it'll probably fall down then. But that doesn't seem to be the case at all. Just up here in front of us, folks, you can see that the path has no handrails. Please walk to the fire station behind. Water on each side of the shower. Yeah, so all of these sandstones here, the only place where there is sandstones in this area, so it's all typically limestone here, but the only place that there's sandstones is at the very top of the mountain. Mm-hmm. And they've all been washed down here.
The texture has been broken off. Is that a river or
formation? A bit of one egg, a bit of one of
it's a medium, just. Your phone, because it's brighter. On this side here, we also have the key of crocodile. Right? Very stony looking. Oh, yes.
It's like, now, it's actually, obviously, not a crocodile. It is a brimstone pool, again, John. And it's the longest one in the cave. It's 12 meters long, half a meter deep. Mm-hmm. Now, does anyone have any questions? Do you mean like in terms of...
early 1990s, right, the ball in my culture was being harvested for perk.
Give me the flash.
Whenever that happens in a dog, the ball loses the ability to retain water. Then he disappears below the water runs out of the so it floods the caves faster. Right. So you might have seen there in Clifton, in Mayo there last week, I was at a really bad storm. The town flooded really badly. The reason why it was because Cuiche and other forestry services increased they plant trees in the bog land, which then reduces the bogs by letting go of water, right?
Yeah.
So that's why the town's flooded.
Yeah.
It's the same here. So basically, the cave used to flood back then in around half hour, right? Which does not really give you that good of time.
Yes.
You know? Like, say if we went up in here, the top gate, right, in half an hour, if one of you fell on the way and broke your ankle, right, you then have the logistical issue of having to figure out how to get you out, having to get a stretcher down here and get you out within that time.
Yes.
Really unsafe, right? So now the caves, because the bog was restored in the late 1990s, early 2000s, the bog now has the ability to retain water. And the caves now today take about 2.5 hours on average to flood. So it's a lot more safe.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, I'm being a bit risky about any of this, but whenever the bog was restored, you get people caving back here so they go actually caving. And they try to go through what's known as a sump, kind of at another part of the cave we haven't been to yet. And because the ball can be restored, the cave floated faster, and they got caught in between. Kind of like, imagine if you were trying to get from the other side of that rock to here, they got caught underneath the rock while the cave was flooded. And all three of them were killed. Right? So, there is an inherent risk to caves here. I mean, that's why you probably don't stand for it to have safety in. So, I suppose that's a really long answer.
You also kind of like, you wouldn't be able to make the protocol for a longer place than a problem, because you put a few miles of water in.
Yeah, basically, yeah.
It's a whole other land for a longer way to be able to
do it. And as well, you have seen near enough every single information you can see. All around that corner there, you just be seeing more of the same thing. You know what I mean? But that is also a thing. So underneath this bridge here, there's a weir, which holds back that water there. Even like this, right? If that weir was to be released, we would have 10 seconds to get to the other side of that bridge there. The weir isn't going to be released, thankfully, and that's why we're also camping here in Max. But that gives you a bit of an idea of it can be. This is a gear engine for my mask. This is a ray on water. And that monitors the gas out here from the ray on. And basically, that's just a natural gas to see out behind the stuff. Okay? We have monitors on.
The flash isn't automatic, but it doesn't go off. But it's okay. Watch your head now.
This is your front stop to passing from the radio. Again, we also have this information here from the top of the side.
Thank you,
Paul. The department is about the past meeting, the side, the right side. And what we haven't seen so far is the passing part of the column. And that there is formed under a static type of strength and seam, which is a static type on the way up, and they eventually fuse together in the middle. So if you come back tomorrow about 3 years to 6,000 years, you'll see the CDO2 developed in the background.
Yeah, they're on. Watch your head.
Here again,
your head.
Thank you.